Oh my god! The gondola's mechanism has broken. I should fix it if I want to return.
We called a truce among all pirate companies for the duration of Captain Remington's wedding. It was supposed to be a great ball for all the sea wolves in the Caribbean. We left our weapons on the ships as an act of good faith, so when Baron Bannister's soldiers showed up, we were defenseless. They butchered us without hesitation, men and women, innocent and guilty alike. But now, Captain Remington is back at last, and he will avenge us so that we may finally rest in peace.
The festivities were beginning when the soldiers rushed in, guns blazing, swords slashing at the crowd. It was a massacre. The grimmest wedding I ever attended. And the last one, too. But tonight, the captain has appeared with a new girl on his arm. Maybe he has found a way to recreate the wedding somehow.
My sword was useless when the slaughter began. In the blink of an eye, the wedding guests were dead or dying. Just before my own death, I saw the Countess crying as her treacherous father rescued her and chained up Captain Remington for execution before her eyes. But now, the captain's voodoo gimmicks might prove useful, and we will see the Countess and him walk down the aisle once again.
Thank you.
During her days aboard Remington's Black Galleon, the captive Mary Bannister turned out to be fearless, peaceful, and resilient as she tried to shun the pirates' advances. Captain Remington was keeping her out of harm's way. On rare occasions, Mary was given permission to visit the deck. Once, to avoid her father's disgrace, she attempted suicide and jumped into the water. Thank you.
Remington jumped in after Mary and saved her from drowning, but the rescued girl soon became feverishly ill. The captain couldn't trust any of his vicious mates, so he personally nursed Mary back to health on Skull Island. During that time, Remington fell in love with the beautiful Countess at his mercy. Mary noticed Remington's feelings and started to care for the legendary pirate.